Welcome friends in my YouTube channel Mining Squad. Today we are going to start the most basic and important book for mining engineering students, that is Elements of Mining Technology by DJ Deshmukh. So friends, hope you all are already aware by this book. This book has three parts, that is volume 1, volume 2 and volume 3. And we will going to complete this book one by one. Okay, you can purchase this book in around 250 to 300 Indian rupees each. Okay, in this video we will only discuss the chapter contents. Okay, so we will have a overview of the chapters and we will aware what we have to know in further chapters. So without any delay, let's get started the video. Guys, there is total 14 chapters are there. We will discuss one by one. So the first chapter is mining geology, minerals, rock and rock structure. In this chapter, what we have to read, the mining geology, minerals, different types of minerals, how can they extract some special types of minerals, rocks, different types of rocks, how they can classify it, and all these things we will read in this chapter. So have a look of this chapter. There is mining geology, mineral, rocks and rock structure. Here you can see minerals. There is given the physical properties of this and chemical properties also, and then after what we have to read in this chapter, some special types of minerals. As I said, we have to read in this chapter all these things. We have to read in this chapter rocks. Yes, rocks, different types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks. Rocks are divided into three parts. They are subdivided further. So these things which we have to read further. Okay, and what is given there? Formation of mineral deposit, how mineral deposit, how can they extract, all these things we have to read in this chapter. So coming to the second chapter is coal and coal fields of India. Different types of coal fields in India we have to read in this chapter. Okay, where they are located, coal, how coal is formed. There are two types of coal is formed. Have a look of this chapter. Have a look of this chapter, coal and coal fields. Okay, now so there is some basic information about coal, energy. Okay, coal, different types of, first of all there is given origin of coal. There are two methods of origin of coal, as I said, drift method and C2 theory. Okay, now so these are some basics of coal, rank of coal, what are the quality of coal. First of things, what are the quality of the coal? So according to their calorific value. Okay, now so how they formed, some history was given. Okay, now coal fields, right, repeated. They are given, as I said, different types of. Okay, now there is the Indian map. There is located different types of coal fields. Okay, now different types of coal fields: Rajin's coal fields, Jharia coal fields, Giritis, and so on. Total 21 coal fields are there, and then lignite fields. Okay, now also, so these all things which I have to read in this. And apart from this, we also have to read about coal washeries, where they are located, different types of coal washeries. We also have to read about these chapters. Now the third chapter about boring. The third chapter is about boring and drilling. We all know the meaning of boring and drilling. What is the function in mining? So let's see. Let's have a look. Mining and drilling and boring. To prove existence of mineral, first of all we have to identify the mineral, the step of mineral deposit, so that we can design our mines. Okay, and also core rocks, which gearing, pressure, ground to be find out to know through faults. Okay, now on the drainage out of gas water from working. Okay, now for blasting purpose we also drilling and boring performed. Drilling and boring almost same. Number of differences, methods of employed for drilling, different types of drilling method, different types of instrument used in drilling. Okay, now we will read in this chapter. And coming to the chapter number 4, shaft sinking. What is shaft sinking method? As we know, in underground mining, to access through mineral deposit, a well like shaft is performed. Okay, now so this is generally called shaft. Okay, now and the process is called shaft sinking. What are the different types of shaft sinking? Okay, there are circular shaft. Most of our circular shaft. Okay, now rectangular shaft is very rare in India. And this is also written there that shaft sinking process is very costly. As you know, contractors amount vary from 50,000 to 75,000 per meter. That is highly costly. And we have to read the different types of shaft sinking methods. And here different types of methods. How can ventilation of shaft sinking and or lining. Okay, now so all these things we have to read in this chapter. These are known as shaft sinking. And the fifth is open cast mining. We all know there are two types of mining: open cast mining and underground mining. In open cast mining, there is less cost than underground mining. Open cast mining, there is no problem of roof supporting, no problem of ventilations in open cast mining. Okay, now in world, 70% mining is open cast, rest 30% is underground. So let's see in this chapter what is given. Open cast mining, there are two types of quarrying: manual quarrying, mechanically quarrying. In mechanical or open cast working, there is lot of HMM, heavy heavy earth moving machines will be performed. So in this chapter we have to also read about different types of HEML. Okay, now first of all, what we have to do in open cast mining? First of all, we have to remove the ore button and then we have extract the mineral. This is also given some advantages of open cast mining. So there is a less hazard, as we know, no roof control, no ventilation problem. Okay, now the efficiency is high, and the disadvantage is the only main disadvantage is that it's weather affected. In summer season, in winter night, it affects the low efficiency of worker, and all these things we have to read in this chapter. Mechanized open cast mining, here is also given mechanized open cast mining. Here we will read a lot of HMMs. Look at there, that is bulldozer and that is sharp earth, their working process there, all these things we have to read in this chapter. So coming to the next chapter, access to the mineral deposits and pit bottom layout. So what is it we have to read in this chapter? Access to the mineral deposit, how we access, how to reach out from mineral deposits. Okay, now so all these things, these are types we have to read in chapter number 6. So have a look in chapter number 6. So yeah, access to a mineral deposit and pit top bottom layout. Access to mineral deposit, how to access, how to reach out from mineral deposit from the surface of the earth to the mineral. Okay, now inclined and audit, there are two types inclined. There have inclined, there are many types of access. Okay, now pit and shaft are there, and we have discussed about shaft. What is shaft? Okay, now shaft here versus inclined. So all these things we have to read in this chapter. So the after that, what we have to read, all these things we have to read in this chapter. And after that, the next chapter is about drainage of rotting coal and coal stones. Okay, now so this is also the same. Okay, now so how to access the mineral deposit by the roads and coal stones, how they make, how there are different types. Okay, now the classification, all these things are also we have to read in these chapters. And after that, explosives, accessories, blasting practice. Okay, now so explosives used in to break down any stone, coal deposits and minerals. So we have to read what types of explosive used, solid, liquid. Okay, now what are the accessories, what are the blasting factories, the classification, there are types, a lot of explosives we have to read in this chapter. So after explosives, accessories, blasting practice, let's see in this chapter. There is given the properties of the following properties of an explosive are interested to its user. It should be a strength, it should be velocity of detonation, density, it must be water resistant, sensitivity, it fume characteristics, legal permissions, and all these things will be here. Okay, so there are in this we have to read the lot of explosives, their types, what are their types of explosives we also have to read in this chapter. Okay, now so there is given the lot of here is the name of companies. Okay, explosives types and companies of different types of explosive, how blasting is performed, all these things that are given in this chapter that we have to read in this chapter. So moving to the next chapter, the next chapter is rock mechanics, roof and roof support. What is given there? Rock mechanics. In this chapter we have to read different types of force acting in rocks. Okay, and roof support and supporting of roof. Okay, now how different types of supports. Okay, there are different types of support, wood and pillar support, and all these things. Okay, we have to read in this chapter. Rock mechanics, different types of forces in rocks. Okay, different types of properties of rocks. Okay, roof support, how to support the roof, there are different types, classification, all these things we have to read in this chapter. So let's move to this chapter's rock mechanics. What we have to read in this chapter? Okay, rock mechanics and roof supports. There is also, as we say, different types of force acting on a material body, iron or steel mine support. These are different types of support, wooden supports, iron or steel for mine supports, and different types of advantage, disadvantage, all things are given in this chapter. To coming to the next chapter, stopping practice. Yes, what is the stopping practice? Look, after mining performed in any mines, okay, now it is filled with sand or any other thing so that surface will be on the level. Okay, so this process is called a stowing practice, and the process is called a stowing practice. So in this chapter we have to read how different types of how can we stowing, the hydraulic stowing, mechanically stowing, the different types of stowing practice we will have to read in this chapter. And all these things, there is, look here, there is given also like hydraulic support, and all these things we have to read in this chapter. Next chapter is about long wall, another method of working process. The next chapter is about board and pillar method of working coal. What are the board and pillar method of working coal and development of mine, board and pillar method. Okay, now board and pillar method. So in the process of coal extraction, this is one method, board and pillar method. Okay, now this method we have to read in very describing this chapter. So let's have a look of this chapter. Here you can see the different type, what are the board and pillar methods. Okay, now how can they perform it, and all these things we have to read in this chapter by this diagram. Okay, now so these blocks are pillars, and these things we have to read in this chapter. The next chapter is about pillar extraction. After gold and pillar method, pillar is to be extracted, that is of coal and mineral. So how they can extract, okay, so how they can extract, there are different types of method to extract. We have to read in this chapter pillar extraction method. And after that we will read along with another method of lithium. These are very effective method of working, my working methods, not manually, the totally mechanized system, long wall method of working. Okay, now so let's see what is long wall method of working. So the second last chapter is long wall, another method of working. This is a standard method of mining extractions, the mineral extractions, long wall mining method. Okay, now mainly these are not performed in India, these are performed in abroad. Okay, now in spite of this, some of mines where the long wall is performed, like in Unity Colliery, and there are somewhere the long wall is performed. Okay, now long wall mining, these are very standard mining method. Okay, now their efficiency is more than manual mining. So the next one is thick seam working. There is given that we seam is economical seam working. The seam called seam means the bed of coal means. Okay, so these all things we have to read in this chapter. So these are the chapters we have to read in this Independence of Mining Technology Volume 1, the basic knowledge about mining. Okay, after completing that we will start the chapter Volume 2 and Volume 3. But before that we will discuss one by one chapter very briefly, and I will provide you in the notes also on the link of description when I will make this videos. Okay, so be updated with our channels. Please like, subscribe, share this video, and please hit this play bell icon so you will find the updated with us. Thank you so much.